Hello guys, my name is Hardeminder. Welcome back. Today I'll tell you how to solve your assignment of 2nd May 2020 which was sent to you. How to solve that and how to extract the folder, everything I'll tell you. First, you need to download your question paper by clicking here. Just click here and wait for few seconds. It has been saved. Now copy this folder. This is our folder. Copy and you can paste it on desktop here and then extract it. That's very important. Extract, students. Click here, then right click here, then extract here. In Windows also you will get the option of extract here. So you need to extract. Very first thing you need to extract, don't keep in mind. Here is a paper of October 2019-20 and you'll have to solve this QP 31, this one 417. This is a QP question paper 31 and this is its source file. Again we need to extract this. We can copy these both things, this and this. These both we need. We can copy it and paste here. This is a question paper which we need to solve. Check here. This spreadsheet, data analysis and web authoring, we need to solve this spreadsheet part. And this is its source file. You need to extract it again. Click here and then extract here. This has been extracted. Now solve this question paper. Evidence document you have to make. Enter your name, center number, candidate number so they appear on every page of the document. Save as a word processed document in your work area with the file name and 19 evidence followed by your candidate number. For example, this and 19 evidence and you will need to place answers to the questions of and screenshots in the evidence document. Open this evidence N19 evidence.rtf. So open it. You need to open this one. Here there is a N19 evidence. Open this. And then they have told so many question papers we have. This is your question paper. Enter your name, center number and candidate number so they appear on every page of this document. We want that your name, candidate number and center number should appear on every page. So that's why we can write in the header or footer. If we will write in header or footer, these information which is in header or footer will display on every page. So we need to insert it in header and footer. Header or footer. Insert. Header. We can write in header. Here I can write my name. Candidate number, suppose there is a 4 times 9. Center number, suppose N001. So this you need to write. And then enter your name, center number and candidate number so that they will appear on every page. Save your word processed document, your work area with the file name and evidence followed by the candidate number and for example this. We need to save it. File save as. By default it will be na and followed by your candidate number. Save it on desktop. Let us desktop save. It will ask for use ODF format or rich text format. It's already in rich text format, RTF. We need to save it in a Word format. So I chosen this. So this has been saved. Let's move further. Save your word processed document, your work area. You need to place the answers or to questions and screenshots in the evidence document. Task 2 spreadsheet, this we need to solve. This was your assignment. You are going to prepare an invoice using a spreadsheet of Super Disk Sales. This company makes and sells storage devices. All prices are in euros, which must be displayed in two decimal places. Open and examine the file invoice.csv and sst.csv in spreadsheet package. We need to open these two files. So come here. First is invoice.csv. Open with LibreOffice Calc. And second is sst.csv. Here is this one. Both the files we have opened. This is a sst.csv and this is a invoice.csv. So let us move further. We have opened. Using a file name invoice.csv, merge cells A1 to G1. This invoice.csv, A1 to G1, we need to merge. Merge these cells. Merge cells A9 to G9. Now we need to merge A9 to G9. Then merge. Then format both merge cells to have a white center aligned 36 point sans serif font and black background. So we need to set their background as a black background. So we need to set the background black. Here we need to choose your background color. So from here we can choose the background color. By default it's already in black white. Automatically it becomes white when I'm making the background color black and foreground color automatically going to be a white. We'll have to set it 36.36. This also. Sorry. Then format the merge cells have white center 36 points and sorry black background. Format the top spreadsheet look like this. That's done. We have already done. So we need to. This already done. This we can set the borders. Borders we need to show as is shown in the picture in the question paper. We need to show the back borders. Click here, select the borders, and increase. Then. Okay. At the bottom of the spreadsheet, format only cells which contain text to be bold and look like this. At the bottom of the spreadsheet, format only the cells which contain text to be bold look like this. Bottom means here we need to set the text only the cells which have a text to be bold. Total items, discount rate, price, before discount, discount, total, like this. Not this one, these one. This, we can press control key while selecting the cells. It will select all cells, otherwise only one cell we can select at a time. Control B is the shortcut to make them bold. We have made them bold. Save the spreadsheet with the name invoice followed by your center number, candidate number, for example invoice, like this. We need to save your file. 9 marks work we have done. Copy. Save as you can keep it on desktop, invoice underscore and your center number, suppose that is a N0001, and your candidate number, suppose that is a 4x9. So we can save it. Again, we need to save it in a ODF format. Saved. 9 marks work we have done. Place the test invoice date followed by an automated date left aligned in the header. Invoice date followed by automated date left aligned in the header. Place your name, center number and candidate number right aligned in the footer. Let us try in the left aligned in the header. Left line. Go in format, then page, then select header and then edit left aligned. We need to write this invoice. Invoice date. Right click, then copy. Here we need to write invoice date. From here, we can select date. And in right hand side, we need to write place your center number, candidate number right aligned in the footer. In footer, we need to set. Okay. And then we need to set in footer, edit. In footer, we need to write. In right aligned, candidate number, center number, candidate number, name. School name is Arvinder Singh, center number N0001, and candidate number suppose is 4x9. So set it. Let's move further. Place functions in cell C12 to F12 to look up the make, model, capacity and unit price of this item using the product code of the lookup value and the external file sst.csv for the array. Let we save that SST file as a save as a ODP. ODF file, so it will be easier for us, make it on desktop also. So let us see what they are asking. Place function in cell C12 to F12, look up the make, model, capacity and unit price of this item using a product code for the lookup value and the external file sst.csv for the array. So this is a C12. Where is C12? Here is C12. C12 to these things we have to put, and we need to look up the values from here. Product code is a lookup value, and this is a product code will be the lookup value. Here we need to make the function lookup, and the product code will be the lookup value. Means we look up from here, we will look up the value, sorry, here, and then from array we need to pick the make from here. This is array. In array, we need to pick the make. Make is in 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 number column. Here also we can write. That is in a 4 number column. and then comma. If value is true, show formula. Actually it's showing the formula, so we have to hide the formula. Click here, show formula. So if we will write any product code here, suppose the product code is this SSD 11, it will show the make here. What is the make? You can select here SSD 11 is of make is not Samsung, this is a Crucial. So we need to check here once again. Yes, once we need to write here 0 instead of 1, means a false, so that it can approximately match the values. So again, for the model, we need to make the formula again. We look up. Then select the array. And then come here, comma. Now we'll need to check the model is in which column. Model is in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 number column. So here we need to write the 5. And 0. Something went wrong. We forgot to write the lookup value. Here we need to pick the lookup value. Lookup value is this. Then comma. Yes, SSD 11. We will check SSD 11. SSD 11, this is its model. Then capacity is in 1, 2, 3, third column. So we can copy the formula, same formula here. Just we need to change the column index. Here we can write the 3. This is A1. Actually, we need to make the reference also. Here is A1 to E106. Here we need to set the reference also. A1 to E106. So let us make the formula again. It's equal to V lookup. This is a lookup value. Then comma. We need to select the array. And that capacity is in third column. So here comma 3 and comma 0. So this is its capacity. Now we need to write the unit price. Again, V lookup. The lookup value is this. Then array we need. Again, select the array. 2 here. And we need a unit price. Unit price in second column. So select here the second 2, then 0. Bracket close, enter. Then price V lookup. This is a lookup value, comma array. Again we need to select the array. And price is in second column. Unit price. Write here 2 and then 0. So guys, this we have completed. I want to remind you, the first parameter is lookup value from where we want to match the values, then array from where we need to pick the values, and then the column index from which column we need to pick the value, then 0 or 1. 0 means approximate match and 1 means exact match. We need the exact match. If the array's data is in ascending order, then when we can do approximate match. If the data is not in ascending or descending order, then we can do the exact match. So here in the question they have told, the data entered in the product column, nothing is displayed in the each of these cells. Place the capacity price of these items using product code values external SV. They have not mentioned anything here. So you can 0 means false, means exact match, and 2 means approximate match, and that is a 1. Keep in mind, make sure that if no data is entered in the product code column, then nothing is displayed in each of the cells. Means if product code is not available, then the array should not print the, suppose the thing, it should not print the error like this. So we need to change, put the function, one more function here. If this value is equal to blank, means nothing is there, then it should print blank, as it should look up the value. So here again we need to write here also same, if here no value is there, then it should print blank, otherwise lookup value. Same here, if in this cell no value, then should blank, otherwise this. Similarly in this also we need to write the same, if in this cell is there, and it should print like it is blank. Here also we need to set the formula like this, if here lookup value is blank, guys, if the product code is blank, means nothing is there, then it should not print any error. This is the condition of that question paper. Replicate these functions from row 13 to 23. If we need to copy these up to 23, these formulas, we need to make them absolute reference. Here we lost the formula, number of items here. So we need to make the absolute reference. Otherwise, this reference we want change. Lookup value will should change A12 to A13, but the range we want, that should not change while dragging down the formula. So that we need to make, means it should not be A1 to A2. And this will not change from E106 to F106. So we need to make them absolute, so that when we will replicate the formula, the reference should not change. For making them absolute, we can press F4 by click, put your mouse here and press F4, and here also F4. So this we have made the absolute reference. Again here F4, and here also F4. Here F4, and here also F4. In this also we need to make them F4 and F4. So this we have made, so that the absolute reference, to make them absolute. So we need to replicate up to 123, up to here. Similarly this one, similarly this one and this one. Yes guys, let's move further. This 15 marks formula we have done. 15 marks is a big weightage of this question we have completed. Place in cell G12 a formula to multiply the number of items by the unit price. In G12 we need to write a formula. G12 is where this is G and in G12 we need to write, let me check again. Place in cell G12 a formula to multiply the number of items by the unit price. So we need to write here a formula. Number of items here multiply by unit price and enter. Here is no value, so it's showing like this. Replicate this. Make sure that if no data is entered, the number of items column that nothing should be displayed. Here also we need to write the same. Error should not be displayed. If number of items are blank, then it should print blank, otherwise multiply. So here we have calculated the price also. Let's move further. Replicate the formula 13 to 23 which we have already done. Place the cell B24 a function to calculate the total number of items ordered in B24. Where is B? Here. B24. Function to calculate the total number of items ordered. So here we can write the count function. Count. To count the values here. No count, here will be a sum, means sum of values, number of items to be ordered, the number of items which we have ordered. Place in G24 function to calculate the total price, total of the price column in G24. And there is a G24, total price we need to calculate here. Sum. Select the range, enter. Place in cell E25 nested if function to display the discount rate percentage referring to the data in the column 1, column I to J depending upon the total number of items ordered. Note that the discount rate is in cell J6 is used if the total number of items ordered does not meet the criteria of cells I3 to I5. So we need to write the formula in cell E25. Nested if function to display the discount rate percentage referring to the data column in I and J depending upon the total number of items ordered. Note that discount rate in cell J6 is used if total number of items ordered does not meet the criteria of cell I3 to I5. So E25 is where. Here is E25, we need to write the formula here. If number of items ordered less than this, then discount rate is this one. But if B24 is less than this I4, then discount rate is this one. Again, if number of items less than this is a B24 is less than this, then discount is this, else this discount, this is the last. So close the all brackets. So we have made the formula. If in B24 the number of items ordered is less than I3 means 10, then discount will be J3 means 0. If in B4 means number of items ordered less than I4 means 20, then the discount rate will be 0.5. If then less than 50, then 0.1. If all these conditions are not meeting, then this 0.2 will be the discount rate. So let's move further. This is a 4 marks question. It's also having a good weightage. Place in cell G25 the formula to calculate a discount amount, which is the discount rate multiplied by the price before discount. So place in G25 a formula to calculate the discount amount, which is the discount rate multiplied by the price before discount. In G25 we need to write the formula. Here G25, where is this? Is this is G25. We need to write the formula here. Price before multiply by discount rate. So here this will be 1 marks question we have done. Apply appropriate formatting to cells containing numeric values in rows 12 to 26. Save your spreadsheet. Print the entire spreadsheet showing the values. Please note you will not yet have entered data into this invoice. We have not entered the data. Make sure printout fits the single page contents of the cells fully visible. No split words, grid lines are displayed, row and column headings are displayed. So this spreadsheet printout you can take out by giving the command. Then print your spreadsheet showing the formula. So after that we need to show the formula, go in view and then show formula. And after that again we need to take the printout. Then move further. Make sure that you have entered the name, center number, candidate number on your spreadsheet showing the formulas. So before the invoice will be used, it needs to be tested. Test 1 will be used normal, including item SST. In your evidence document, edit the evidence 1 table to look like this. Test 1, type test SST. Cell Y selected first product in the data source, and this you'll have to set the data by selecting the different normal, extreme and extreme data or normal data or abnormal data you can enter in that. Examine the formula in G12 and use the complete table identifying test 1 normal, means you need to write the normal data in formula in G12. Examine the formula in G12. Where is G12? Here is G12. So we need to examine this formula. G12, where is this is G, and here we need to examine the formula. For that we need to write the product ID here. Product ID you can write, suppose that is a SST 12. Number of items ordered, suppose 20. Discount rate is 0.1, 20.005. That should be 0.1. We have done something wrong here. We have to recheck. Means formula is showing 0.1, but we have entered 20. Greater than, it should be less than 20. If the values are greater than 20, means less than means up to 19. If the values are greater than 20, then this this discount rate will be applied. So we need to enter the normal data. So we can enter 25. So this is correct. Means 0.1 is a normal discount rate. That's good. And unit price is 24, 2100, and 210 as a discount. So after discount, I think we need to calculate. They have not asked in question. After discount, what will be the amount we need to check here? So I think 1890 will have to pay by the customer. So this we have checked. Test 1, in the cell reference where the item test data will be entered, why do select the item of test data? The expected outcome of test 1 that will be seen in the G12. Edit the complete and table in the evidence document. We have to write test 1 normal. Item of the test data is SST1, suppose. And then cell Y, selected first product in the data to check the normal outcome. But expected outcome in G12, what is the expected outcome in G12? We can write this is G12, the same we have to write in your evidence document. There you can write it. So let us move further. Enter the address as shown in the format. Edit the complete table, this 5 marks. Enter the address as shown in the format. It looked like this. Tawara Technology Solutions. Enter the items into invoice like this. First we need to write this function, Tawara Solutions. Here. Then we need to merge these cells. Tawara Technology Solutions. Then this 32-bit avenue. Then Tawara and then this one. And then we need to write this and enter the product code, this number of items 10 and this. Let us check product code, this one SST8 and this one SST34. SST34. Number of items 10 and 1. Items 10 and 1. Print only cells A1 to G26 showing the values. Make sure that printout fits all the single page, row, column, headings not displayed. Contents of all cells are fully visible with no split words. Make sure you have entered the name, center number and candidate number on all the. This 49 work we have done and we have to take the printout from A1 to 26. And in this way we have completed the test. And hope you have learned well. According to this we have already solved this question paper. These are total items 11. According to that, 0.5 discount is required, and this is a discount, and all we have done. Thank you very much.